see. Enthusiastic's how you need to be.
Respect is his golden rule. Organized to be the best in school. Sycamore teachers teach the kids new things. Money doesn't stop until the last bell rings, rings, rings. Super Sycamore comes out at night. STEM and super work that students do right. If you want Super Sycamore to notice you, don't be discouraged when something is hard to do. Work hard and be excited. Show respect and organize. And to the top, you will rise.
Episode 78, Hero Headache. In our last episode of Super Sycamore, we saw Digital Deviant try to sabotage our hero by leaving a poisoned pie. Too bad Mr. Biako ate it instead. We also saw him try tackling Super Sycamore and try shrinking him with a virus-encoded piece of super work. But without a name to show whose work it belonged to, Super Sycamore didn't fall for that either. Through his failures, Digital Deviant realized that to stop Super Sycamore, he needed to go into his brain and make him forget how to super stamp. He googled structure of a superhero's brain so that he could have a map of how a superhero's brain works. It turns out the brain has different regions for different functions. Let's see. There are sections for super stamping, dreaming, flying, rescuing cats from trees, being positive, bucket filling, and hard work sandwiches. Now that Digital Deviant knows how Super Sycamore's brain thinks, he'll get in there, destroy the cortex, and then the synapses will stop firing neurons. Translation, it'll shut down Super Sycamore's ability to super stamp. The challenge with the plan is figuring out how to get small enough to... Oh, yeah. Digital Deviant grabbed the virus-encoded work. Rather than shrinking Super Sycamore, he'll shrink himself. He's gonna need this. Meanwhile, you know where to find our bucket-filling friend. There's so much amazing work around SCE that Super Sycamore is hard at work giving his stamp of approval to things showing hero characteristics: hard work, enthusiasm, respect, and organization. Work like the bright elf on a shelf word problem from second grader Kinsley in Mrs. Miller and Mr. Biako's class. The work is shown clearly and organized. Speaking of organized, no teacher is more organized than Mrs. DeShong. And few students are more organized than Vivian Duncan. Just what Super Sycamore loves to see. He loves stamping and he loves helping. Now Miss Pam doesn't have to mop that tiny spot. Outside Mrs. Nichols' first grade room, Sean's koala paragraph is full of interesting facts. Super Sycamore leaves a message to wish Mrs. Sparling's first graders hugely happy holidays. First graders are thankful for a lot of stuff on this thankful tree. Pizza, snow, family, butterflies. Yep, those are all great things to appreciate.
Good, your baby Yoda word problem is. Yes.
Nice job, Caitlin Schlosser. While Super Sycamore is super stamping, the Digital Deviant eagerly awaits for his big brother to run out of energy and drift to sleep so that he can shrink himself and get inside the hero's head. The preschool foam snowmen look so real, it's like they're actually made of snow. That handsome fella looks familiar. Check out the murals that are popping up around the school. This guy's a gingerbread so it doesn't get eaten by a fox. Well, those are perfect disguises. Who would want to eat Super Sycamore? What could you turn this snowman into? How about hair? Remember, folks, Super Sycamore loves to get letters in his mailbox. Our hero loves to hide in the firefighter holiday toy drive box, but there isn't room because it's full of toys. That's a great problem to have. The SCE staff is snow awesome. Meanwhile, Digital Deviant finds stuff to do as he continues to wait for Super Sycamore to run out of energy. I suppose the bright side of one-man tic-tac-toe means you're guaranteed to win. An abacus? What kind of magic is this? Mrs. Tinsley's kindergartners have a lot of cool stuff to do during their rug time. What do you notice and wonder about Hanukkah? Our new instructional coaches, Mrs. Horsford and Mrs. Bianco, are straight up amazing.
I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry.
In the media center, Super Sycamore can't contain his excitement because he loves, loves, loves reading.
I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas.
He pauses by the fire to warm his hands and backside.
Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad.
Meanwhile, Digital Deviant? Yep, still waiting.
Feliz Navidad.
At this point, Digital Deviant is so bored that if Super Sycamore doesn't fall asleep soon, he might. Looking for something to do? His activity of choice is snooping. Outside the art room, Mason's quick draw makes Super Sycamore want to come over to his house for a snowball fight. Mrs. Brown's students are learning about the planets. Hannah shows what she sees when she looks at Mercury. And what we see is awesomeness with her work.
Feliz Navidad.
He gives a super stamp to Calvin Tenner's shark essay, and then looks around to find the wall swimming with others to stamp too.
Yeah, I go by Cal Massey, a.k.a. Santa Claus for the evening.
In the third grade pod, Mrs. Spencer's and Mr. Henneman's Monster Lab posters are so fantastic that it's hard to choose which ones to stamp. So here's a gigantic one for all of them. Creativity shines through with drawings and descriptions.
Horse open sleigh.
Building a snowman and having lots of fun because we got presents today.
Bells on bobtails ring, making spirits bright.
We got a good look at...
In fourth grade, Mr. Strawsbaugh's and Mrs. Fannin's kids are learning about the biotic and abiotic factors of an ecosystem. And the poster made by Nahum, Shadvik, and Ethan is by Awesome. Outside Mr. Davis's class, Raylan's comic strip summary of the poem Dust of Snow is artistic and imaginative. Amazing. The candy canes from the preschoolers give everybody holiday cheer.
Cause all we have to do today is laugh and play while we sing and we jingle all the way.
Yeah, he's still waiting. Is a snow angel without snow a no angel?
Jingle, jingle,
jingle,
jingle all the way.
After after a full day of super stamping so much super work, Super Sycamore is an exhausted yet happy hero. He retires for the evening to have a snack and get caught up on his shows. What's his snack of choice on this night? Wheat Thin Crackers with an extra dash of salt and pepper. I'd be lying if I said that sounded good. Moments later, only the sound of snoring is coming from our hero. And that, boys and girls, is music to our villain's ears. This digital deviant slinks into the room with a virus-encoded superwork that will get him into Super Sycamore's brain. After checking to make sure he's really asleep, Digital Deviant places the work over Super Sycamore. He gives it a not-so-super stamp, and in he goes. So this is what it's like to be in the mind of a superhero. It's actually pretty peaceful. I expected more zapping and lightning and stuff. It appears it's also not what Super Sycamore's brother expected. This is pretty cool. It looks like Super Sycamore is in a dream, and it seems pretty normal. In this one, it looks like he's flying. I hope Digital Deviant doesn't have acrophobia, which is being afraid of heights. This next section must be about things that bring Super Sycamore joy, like spending time with people he loves during the holidays. Digital Deviant thinks this is kind of interesting, but he really needs to find the section that super stamps, because everyone knows that if you forget how to stamp in your dreams, then you'll forget in real life. And this isn't that section. I'm guessing this is the part of his brain that tells Super Sycamore that he's hungry and needs to eat 374 hot dogs slathered in mustard. Outside Super Sycamore's brain, our purple pal gets a little restless and wakes up. He's confused by a piece of paper placed on his face. And thanks to too much pepper, he feels a sneeze coming on. Back inside the noggin, his brother Sam, now the digital deviant, has found the stamping center of the brain. There's super stamps everywhere. But before he can push the button, Digital Deviant is interrupted by the bedtime snack coming back to attack. The pepper that Super Sycamore had eaten caused him to sneeze, which caused a rush of spit, snot, and Sam to come flying out of Super Sycamore's nose into a tissue. Feeling better after a solid sneeze, Super Sycamore decides that if he's up, he may as well be productive. So he heads out to find something to do. Digital Deviant, on the other hand, isn't having a good night. Not only was he stopped by a pepper sneeze from making his brother forget how to stamp, but even worse, he's now covered with, well, let's just say he needs a bath. For some reason, Super Sycamore's brother was on his mind, so he decides that he wants to make him a gift. He heads to the STEM room supply closet for some supplies. He makes a present and goes to leave it for his brother to find. Remember, treating others with kindness is always the perfect gift.
We've been waiting all year for this night. When the snow is glistening.
Now it's time to find out who SCE's Heroes of the Month are.
By your side, waiting for
Aubrey Kenner, you are a Hero of the Month. Aubrey is helpful, a great listener, and has the hero qualities every day, all day. William Hughes, you're a hero of the month. William comes to school ready to learn, is kind, helpful, and makes the hero choices all of the time. Ezra Ford, you're a hero of the month. Ezra is a hard worker who makes great choices in and out of the classroom and is a great friend to his peers. Ruby Burke, you're a hero of the month. Ruby is always smiling, is empathetic towards her friends, and shows perseverance because she never gives up. Muhammad Jai, you are a hero of the month. Muhammad tries his best, asks questions, follows school rules, and is respectful to his classmates. Autumn Wilson, you're a hero of the month. Autumn is a hero model in the hallway, cleans up the room, and helps others clean as well. Autumn is an amazing kid. Hudson McGrath, you're a hero of the month. Hudson approaches each day with a positive attitude, also known as a hero attitude. Congratulations to all of SCE's heroes of the month. Keep acting like heroes, and maybe next month it could be you.
Oh yeah, blessings from above, God sent you his love.